Sally. Hi, Pearl. Let me know if you can hear me all right. Hi, Rosemary, Lena, Sarah. Hello. Hi, Lorraine. Oh, Kathy's here. Hello, Australia. Can anyone tell me if you can hear me okay? From Australia again, yes, sounds good. Okay, if you can hear me, that's the main thing. And hopefully you won't have any, there won't be any focus issue like there was last time. I put the camera a bit higher, so there shouldn't be any focus problem. Hi, Haley. Loud and clear, says Lorraine. How are you, ladies? It's lovely to see you again. It's been a while. I did say every 2 weeks. I can't even keep up with that. Coucou, Sylvie. Ah ben voilà, tu vas voir comment j'ai fait ta carte en direct. Comment vous allez tous bien? How is everyone? Beautiful stamps, yes they are. And guess what? You're going to be able to enter to win some. How about that? Bonjour, hello from the Netherlands. Hello, hello Netherlands. I don't even know how to say hello in Dutch or bonjour. I don't even know. I need to learn. My daughter wants to go and study, wants to go to a university in the Netherlands. So I will have to learn a bit because I will visit. How am I? I'm okay. I'm good. I'm good. We went to the restaurant for the first time in ages for lunch. So I had a few glasses of wine. So you'll have to forgive me if I'm just like shaking too much. Just kidding. I'm kidding about the shaking. I'm not kidding about the wine. But it was so nice to be able to go to the restaurant again. It's crazy how something as simple as going for a meal like sounds amazing all of a sudden. Hello in Dutch. Okay, hello then. Same as German if I'm not mistaken. My German is rusty, but I did study for a few years. Cold in East Sussex. It's not cold here. It's grey, but it's warm. It's like about 23 degrees. It's actually really nice out there. Ah, moi, Béatrice. Ça, je le savais. Je ne sais pas si je le prononce bien, mais je savais que moi, c'est joli ou beautiful. That's probably the only word I know in Dutch. Well, I know two now. I know hello, so that's okay. Christina Barker, hello. I'm going to wait a few more minutes. Have you guys been all okay? Not too sure what's happening in the other countries now. I think everyone's starting to live again, which feels good. I'm going to drink a bit of my tea because I know we'll forget it afterwards. Alright, so I think I'm going to make a start, 3 o'clock. I always start a bit before to say hi to everyone, but I like to start on time. So, I can't show you the card that I'm going to make because I've already sent it. Well, actually, I didn't send it. I gave it to my friend Sylvie, who's watching. Haley says, going to the cinemas in Lewis on Wednesday. Well, that's another thing I'm looking forward to, probably next week. I'm just letting everyone go first, and then I'll go. Oh, so it's okay, so Lorraine, I'm sure you'll catch up later. No worries. So I was saying, I don't have the card, the original card that I'm making, but then I never make twice exactly the same. So I've got the copy of it in front of me. I just printed something to remember what I did. And I'm going to make something as similar as, but in different colors, because I hate making the same thing twice. And also that was a birthday card I gave to one of my closest friends, so I don't want someone else to have exactly the same. So I'm gonna do a bit different. Definitely a different color scheme. Hello from Germany, Guten Tag. I was saying hello in all languages, so. Sue Davis, hello. Sylvie qui dit qu'elle vient de mettre ses haut-parleurs. Ah ben c'est bien, je crois que c'est la première fois que tu es là quand je fais un live, il me semble, je crois. Il me semble. Normalement, tu travailles, donc. Parce que je le fais le vendredi, normalement. Hello from Belgium. Oh my God, we've got everyone here today. Netherlands, Belgium, Germany, England, France. Although I haven't seen many French. Est-ce qu'il y a plus de Françaises autres que Béatrice et Sylvie là qui n'ont pas parlé, qui n'ont pas fait un petit coucou? Allez-y, hein, n'hésitez pas. Oui, une Brems, ouais. Bah oui, bah, il y a une première fois à tout. Hein. Et un jour, il faudra qu'on se fasse un double live, Sylvie. Ce serait cool, ça. On peut faire ça sur Facebook, je sais pas, mais sur YouTube, on peut. C'est marrant. Ok, so, card, which I don't have, but I'm going to show you the stamps I'm using, all kinds of craft. So, I am using the digital pourpre or foxgloves in English. I'll show you that afterwards. I'm going to use the water droplets or les gouttes de pluie en français. I'm going to use this one, which I keep on using everywhere at the moment. I love it. Which is not called Les Fleurs Sauvages, which is what's written here. Béatrice, qu'est-ce que t'as fait? Borders something. Doodle borders. Béatrice, come to help, please. Because it's written Les Fleurs Sauvages on mine. It's not Les Fleurs Sauvages. So it's a border something. But anyway, you're going to put the links, Béatrice, aren't you? And this one is one of the latest ones as well. It's brilliant because you can really literally put that everywhere. And I love it. I really do. So that's the 4A5 I'm using. And I'm going to use this one, which is an older one. And again, I keep on putting that thing everywhere on every card at the moment. I'm addicted to that stamp. Bordure. On s'appelle Bordure. And Australia. Sorry, 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 Cathy. And I know you stay up very late, especially for the live. I'm so sorry. And Australia. Usually we have the US or Canada sometimes, but not today, I think. So that's the stamps I'm using. Stencil-wise, and Beatrice will put the links for everything at one point. Stencils, I'm using Giovanna's GeoGeoCraft stencils. So that's the diamond one, which I designed with her. One of the latest one I've designed with her, and that's one of her. Come see, you got to see on that one of her ATC ones, which I will use for the smaller panel, and that's the diamond one. Okay. Hello from England. Oh, Delphine est là aussi. Bah, décidément, c'est super ça. So that's the stamps. Now you will have the opportunity to win one of these four stamps, one of each, your choice, not my choice. You will win one, but you will be the one choosing in amongst those four. So I will tell you later how to enter. I'm not going to tell you just now, but that wouldn't be fun. Yeah, during this live you will win one of these. Or the little one if you want, I don't mind, but I'm pretty sure you'll go for a bigger set. Paper-wise, card-wise, I'm using, what's it called, a Stillman & Bern watercolor paper. The beta one? Okay, go away, Delphine, go away. I'm kidding. You just came and say hi, right? Hello, Heike. Oh, hello. So yeah, I would get there. Still man and burn. I told you I had a few glasses of wine for lunch. That's the watercolor paper, just black for the matting. The card itself will be an A5. So therefore, these ones are that's 20 by 13.8. So it's basically an A5, take away 1 centimeter. So that's 8 inches by 5.5 inches. That's the bigger panel. And the smaller one is 15.5 by 9 centimeters, which is 6 inches by 3.5 inches. Okay, I will put all the details that you need to know on the description. Maybe not on Facebook. What I'm planning to do is edit this live to make a faster video to put on YouTube, in which case I will put all the details there. But I mean, you'll find out soon enough. Les Bordeaux is very cool, Beatrice. Yes, I agree. I really, really like this one. You can put that anywhere too. Really love it. Yes, just a little high. So I've already gone ahead and stamped the flowers and cut them out because that takes time. And honestly, you're not coming here to watch me cut out. So I've used, let me take that out so you don't have any reflection. I've used this one and I've used this one and I've used this one. You've already seen me use this on. Hold on. The little art journal. On this one. No, not this one. Ah, come, things I can't show you. On this one. So that's this one here and this one here. And the water droplets as well. Yeah, no, that's it for this one. I don't know if I did it on a bigger one. I don't think so. I used it on a card, I think. I can't remember. I know I've used it again, but I can't remember how. Love the fox glove. Yes, so do I. I really, really, really love this. I love that you've got the stem as well, which you can add to any flower, which is brilliant. Hi, Caroline. How are you? So I've cut the flowers. I'm going to use the water droplet, and we're going to use a couple of resist techniques on the same card so you can see the difference. Not that I find that there is much difference, but you will have you choose which way you want to do it. And color wise, I've changed it. So my card originally was blue and purple, but I don't want to do the same. No, blue and yellow, sorry. But I'm going to do yellow and purple for this one. So when I choose the colors to make a card, the way I go for it is I will always use a couple of yellows or blues or whatever, but several shades of one color. Then I will add a neutral with it, so in which it's usually gray, or in the distress, I often use the antique linen as well. And then I use a complementary color. So for the background, I will use these a lot and then a little bit of this. And I will not mix the yellow and the purple, because if you have watched my color theory live, I've already explained that if you mix two complementary colors, then you will get mud or brown or some kind of weird color that can be good sometimes, but not in this case. So put them next to each other, but don't mix them. And I will purposely mix it so you'll see what I mean. And no, that's pretty much it. I think I'm going to start now. Oops. So, droplets. two resist techniques I'm going to use today. I'll leave that afterwards. If you have any question as we go along, I'm keeping an eye on the iPad next to me, so go for it and I will answer. Let's take three of them. I didn't bring my little dusty bag thingy. That's not good. Oh well, never mind. So a couple of ways to do the resist technique. One is the phobotique, which I'm sure many of you know. I mean, I'm not inventing anything today. Huh? It's all something you all know already. But there's always beginners out there, so I don't want to forget about them. Or sometimes you haven't used the technique for a long time, you want to do it again. So I'm using VersaFine here, black, which I'm going to stamp on this side first. Well, it's no point putting this one because we won't see it afterwards. And then on the other side, so that will be, so two resist technique, as I was saying. On this side, I'm going to do the phobotique one. On this side, I'm going to do the one with Vaseline or petroleum jelly, call it the way you want. Or actually, I've got distressed glaze here, which is exactly the same as Vaseline, except 5 times the price. So up to you, use whatever you have. I'm just thinking, yes, I've got that. So, try this. So that's what I will do on this side, and on the other side, I will use the phobotique technique and I need my powder, my VersaMark. I'm going to put that here. Don't know why I put such a, I'm using such a huge acrylic block. Let's put some powder straight away before it dries. I'm going to stamp that again. One at the bottom. I love this one, so cute. Okay, so let's put some powder on those. The extra powder and use the anti-static bag. No preference for the embossing powder. I mean, I'm using that one. That's a stamp Pandas I've had for like 15 years. So I tend to buy wow powders now, but I'm not gonna throw this one away. Does the job, the detail one. It's clear powder, Monique. It's detail clear. But it doesn't matter because we're going to take it away afterwards. But at least the clear, when you remove it, like even if there is still a bit left, it won't show. If you use white, white would have covered the black anyway because the white is opaque. So I want the inside of the droplet to be white as well. So I'm going to use a Versamark pen and fill, you're welcome, and fill the inside because I want to put powders in that as well. I think my Versamark pen is fairly dry. So what I'm going to do is do it in two things because otherwise it's not gonna, it will dry too quickly. I need to get a new Versamark pen. This one is like the powder, it's very old. By doing this, we're going to create a resist, and when we add the color to the background, the droplets will remain white, which is what I want, so I want them to really stand out. Je vais expliquer un petit peu en français. Je sais qu'il n'y a pas beaucoup de françaises pour l'instant, mais je sais qu'il y en a qui regarderont en replay après. Donc j'utilise deux techniques de résist, en fait, parce que je veux que mes gouttes d'eau restent bien blanches. Donc à droite, je vais utiliser du Distress Glaze ou alors vous pouvez utiliser de la vaseline, ça fait exactement le même effet. Je peux vous dire ce que j'ai essayé l'autre jour, mais ça coûte beaucoup moins cher. Et dans ce côté-là, j'utilise la technique du faux batik, c'est-à-dire d'embosser en clair, après on met la couleur et après on utilise le fer à repasser pour enlever cet embossage. Je t'en ai acheté des marqueurs à embosser. Tu m'as acheté des marqueurs? Qu'est-ce que tu racontes? Des Versamark? Still working though, the mark is a bit dry, but still working, still does the job. All right, so now I've got all my droplets from the left which are embossed in clear, therefore it will resist the color. And on the right side, I'm going to use the Distress Glaze, or again, you can use Vaseline if you have some, it does the job. Same thing, I've literally tried it, it's a shame I didn't keep the tags, but I tried it on two tags the other day, one using Distress Glaze, one using really cheap Vaseline or petroleum jelly, and it does exactly the same thing. So on this side, Pardonnez, là. Non, une autre marque. Ok, ben, je ne me rappelais pas. Faudra m'en envoyer un. Alors, Sylvie, on peut laisser l'embossage. Oui, d'ailleurs, sur ta carte, je l'ai laissé. Vu que c'est des gouttes d'eau, c'est joli de le laisser en... Mais là, je vais l'enlever pour montrer la technique, mais c'est vrai qu'on peut le laisser. So, I'm just using a bit of jelly. The tool I'm using here is called a color shaper. It's plastic at the end. It's something we use with, I believe, with clay. Not that I've ever used it with clay. I use it when I do my pastel drawings to mix up the colors and like really, it comes in all sorts of sizes and shapes. I'll show you the others which I use for when I do some pastel paintings. It's plastic, so it's very easy to clean. You just have to rub it off and it will clean off. And it is called Color Shaper. I don't know if I come closer, I don't want it to go blurry, but I will put a link, or Beatrice, if you find it on Amazon or something, can you put a link somewhere, please? And it's really handy for that kind of thing. So I'm just taking a bit and I will put it on. The droplets. You don't need much. I mean, you see me taking the glaze each time, but I'm really not putting much on there. Oh, thank you, Monique. That's nice of you. As I said, I will make a shorter, quicker time-lapse version. Which I will put on YouTube as well, so it will be easier to and quicker to watch afterwards. I think that's what I'll do from now on. So I'll leave the full live on Facebook for those who want to watch it again, and I will put a time lapse of the same thing on YouTube. I just need to find the time to do it, that's all. Just adding the glaze everywhere. And my ink is not quite dry. I can see that because it's. I'll just put some. It's a bit grey now, but. J'ai oublié le nom de l'outil. Color Shaper. A color shaper. It's Royal Sovereign Limited who does that. So to clean it, as I said, you just. Je l'ai pas dit en français, c'est-à-dire je vais le dire en français pour celles qui regarderont après. Donc ce sont des outils en silicone en fait qu'on utilise normalement avec. Je sais plus comment on dit clay en français. Au secours. Bon ben voilà, je sais plus. Tant pis. Et donc moi je les utilise dans mes peintures au pastel quand je fais des peintures et qu'il faut mélanger les couleurs dans des endroits tout petits où mes doigts sont trop gros, donc j'utilise ça pour ça et c'est comme ça que j'ai connu ces outils. Mais c'est pratique aussi pour ça, pour étaler la vaseline ou le distress glaze quand vous voulez mettre ça pour faire un résiste sur vos cartes. Ok, now colors. So, as I said, I'm using two shades of yellow. And a gray, yeah, neutral. So, whatever color you use, two shades of blue, two shades of orange, whatever, and a neutral. Ça résiste tellement bien que. So I need to leave room for the purple as well. Let me add a bit more lemon. Oh, thank you, Monique. Appreciate that. Hi, Rini. Is it Rini? Rini from the Netherlands? Sorry if I don't pronounce your name well. Right, so yellow, and I'm leaving a bit of room for the purple. I need to add a bit of gray, but not too much. I love the effect here. And here actually, pretty, I really like that. So before I do that, I need to do the same on the little one. The links for the pencils, thank you. So, colors, maybe you want squeezed lemonade in my hair, and scattered straw for the yellows, and I'm using hickory smoke for the gray. I don't need to put anything in the middle because a bit more yellow on that side. There we go. So we'll clean that up. And I'm going to add the purple. Purple, I have wilted violet and I've got dusty concord. I'm going to keep that to color. I want something more rather bright, so I'm going to keep that and I'm going to put a bit of yellow there to show you what I said earlier. So, purple on the side. And I need a bit down here and a bit on here. Here we go. And I'll use this one. I'll put a little bit, but not too much, because I'll have my purple flowers on there, so I don't want to have too much purple on the background. Just a little touch. Now, I wanted to show you, as I said earlier, if you mix two complementary colors together, so the complementary colors are the colors opposite each other on the color wheel, that's how you get mud. I often get people asking me, oh, why do I get mud when I do this or that? It's because you mix, I'm trying to find a card, you mix two complementary colors together. So if I was to mix some purple and some yellow together, you will see that that's how you get that kind of brownish, muddy color. Yeah. Which is why I put them next to each other, and then it really stands out because they're complementary colors, so they will complement each other, but I never mix them together because then I will get that color. I would, when, as a watercolorist, I will use that in my watercolors, but when I make a card and I really want colors to stand out, then I'm not doing it. Well, that did happen a bit here, but it doesn't matter. Okay, any question? Lovely stamp, of course it is. It's yours. Ce que je viens d'expliquer pour les couleurs, c'était bien sûr quand je l'ai expliqué déjà dans mon live sur la théorie des couleurs, de ne pas mélanger, sauf si vous voulez avoir du marron, mais de ne pas mélanger les couleurs complémentaires les unes aux autres, donc un violet et un jaune qui sont des couleurs complémentaires, si vous les mélangez, vous obtenez une espèce de marron pas beau, au lieu d'avoir des couleurs qui sont vraiment vibrantes comme elles le sont là sur la carte. going to is use a bit of water. On my droplets, because it's embossed in clear, anything that's on top of the droplet will come off. And on here it doesn't work as much, so it will work better with a full batik because there's really a resist with the thing. I mean, it works here, but not as much as this one. That's the one with the vaseline. Or the distress glaze, call it the way you want. Right, so now I'm going to stamp the background and stencil it. So stamp, I'm going to use the mini background, this one. And stencil, I'm going to use Giovanna's stencil. So I've got a lot of gray here, so I'm going to stamp really like gray on gray or yellow on yellow, that kind of thing. I would have preferred using Hickory Smoke Distress, not Oxide, but I don't have it. And having trouble finding it, actually. So I'm going to do that here, I'm going to put a bit on here. Any question, anyone? I'm going to put a bit of purple dots. And what else? Where's Brian? Brian is in the kitchen. And I'm going to use, I'm going to use the stencils. So I think Beatrice will put a link to the stencils. Loving the mini stamps. Yeah, I know. I love this one too. Not a problem. Too many nice stamps. After that, I'm going to use this one. This one. That's not going to show much this way. Ah bah ouais, tu peux les remettre les liens plusieurs fois, Béatrice, pour ceux qui arrivent après. Allez, allez, tu vas pas faire ta feignante non plus, hein. Je te fasse bosser, hein. So that's my background, so let's have a look. I'll put that here. And I'm going to put a bit on here and use the other one. Just playing with it. Are you making crafts at the same time? Jill says, love seeing how it all comes together. Thank you. That's the whole point, isn't it? The whole fun about it. So, no, I'll do it in a darker yellow. Moi aussi. C'est bien si vous faites toutes des cartes en même temps, c'est cool. Hold on, let me put my ink pad on the side. It's much easier. I'm gonna go again on this one. Merci Béa. Right, so that's my main one. And then I'm gonna add a bit of stamping. I'm really gonna destroy that four. No, still there. Let's put this one away. Let's use the borders. So that I don't need right now. Put that aside. Paper there. I'm trying to keep it rather clean and tidy so it's not a mess. That's not nice for you, nor for me. Let me have a little drink. Okay, so let's add a bit of contrast. So I'm using again the bordure. Put it straight, be nice. Let's put that here, and then, ah, il y a ma maman qui est là. Bonjour, maman. I love it when my mom shows up. A third one on a little card. Who said I need that sheet, Monique? Yeah, I know. It's good, eh? Stop now. What do you want mean stop now? Yeah, the border stamp is very so versatile, that's for sure. You can do so much with that. That's really a must-have, if I may say. Let's do a bit of. Pourquoi tu m'as dit stop, Béa? Okay, so it's a final touch. Just a little bit of flowers at the top. Non, stop. Ah, je répondais à Monique. D'accord. Wonderful stamps, I agree. I agree. Right, so let's get back to the resist for a minute because I will have to change that. So on this side, I still have a bit, even though I did put the glaze, it did color a bit the droplets. They're not completely white. So yeah, I could always go with over with gouache or, you know, whatever, but I'm not going to do it. I don't care. On this side, you see that it resisted a lot better. Now you have two options. Because it's droplets and it looks like water, you can leave it glossy like this. But because I said I would show you the faux boutique technique, I'm going to go all the way. Thank you, Christina. Monique is back. So let me plug the iron. We'll let that warm up for a minute. And as the iron warms up, I will watercolor those little guys. Bleach. No, I'm not using bleach. God, stop it with your bleach. It's not safe for your lungs. I'm sorry, but no. Stop telling people to use bleach. Don't use bleach, people. Especially not in a spray. No. Oh, I'm using a brush that put in the water and it's actually all white. Okay. Right. So, oh, I hate that brush. Okay, let's do something different. Hold on. Bleach. No, don't use bleach. Not good. That's the thing, once you're used to a good watercolor brush, you can't use a crappy one. Ah, that's better. Well, you don't use it in spray, but some people do it. Or they put, what is it called, the stuff you use with alcohol inks? The blending solution. I've seen that. I've seen videos where people put that in sprays. Don't. That's like so bad. Oh yeah, it gets really cool effect by putting the blending solution in a spray. Yeah, your lungs will thank you, ladies. You see so many stupid things sometimes. Right, some president want to drink it too. Yeah, some former president. There's a reason why he's not president anymore. Let's drink bleach to get rid of COVID. Well, at least it would have made us laugh. Except that some people did it and died, though, having said that, which is the saddest part. Any questions, ladies? As I'm adding color to my beautiful foxgloves. Tu veux te présenter à la présidentielle? Béatrice, ta concurrence à Macron? The blonde one is also bleached. So I'm using, I didn't say it because you saw me do it, but obviously I'm using the same color as my background to color my Which is wilted violet again. Purple, so pretty. And I'm not a purple person at all. I really like this one. Ah, coucou Nathalie, t'as trouvé le bon live, hein? C'est bien. Tu t'es pas trompée cette fois. Okay, let's talk about the stamp draw. Parce qu'il ne faut peut-être pas oublier qu'il y a des tampons à gagner dans cette histoire. Il me faut un petit coup de verre là. Un verre qui va aller avec ça. I would say this one. Need a little touch of green. And because I'm putting some on here, I'll have to put a bit in background as well. So let's talk about that winner stamp competition. Well, competition, not competition, it's a draw. It will be a draw. So you can win one of the four A5 stamps that I'm using. I will show them in a second. The choice will be yours. Once I've picked the picture of done the draw for the winner, you will be able to choose which one you want. Donc c'est vous qui choisirez, donc je vais vous donner le choix entre quatre tampons. Aujourd'hui, vous allez juste mettre votre nom si vous voulez gagner quelque chose. Et si jamais vous gagnez, je vous donnerai le choix quant à la planche que vous pouvez gagner. Cookie tire au sort. Cookie, yeah, my cat's gonna do the draw, that's for sure. He's sleeping outside on the table, actually. I saw him earlier. Lazy thing. Okay, so what's gonna be the word today? Let's think. Let me finish that, and then I'll show you the stamps again, and I'm gonna think of what word. You will have to put in a comment in order to win the stamps. Anyone who's on the Cattle Craft design team cannot enter the draw, obviously. Neither can members of my family. Donc toute personne qui est sur la design team de Cattle Craft ne peut pas participer au tirage au sort, et les membres de ma famille ne peuvent pas participer non plus. Un petit peu normal. So I need a bit of green on the background. So bleach, non, c'est pas le mot magique aujourd'hui. Je vais juste rajouter un petit peu, voilà, de vert pour que ça aille avec voilà. Et un petit peu sur celui-là aussi. If I put green on the main one, I need to add a bit of green on the background as well. Not much, but just a little touch would be enough. You're already spoiled by Beatrice. Yeah, I know. She does spoil people, doesn't she? Well, she spoils me. I'll be honest, she really does. Ironing. That's the only time that you will enjoy ironing. So to remove that, now remember, I stamped with Versamark, I put clear embossing powder, I'm adding my color, and now I'm gonna remove the glossy part of it. It will act, so that acted as a resist. And the droplets will be bright white. Pardon pour le bruit. Je vais redire ça en français. Donc j'avais tamponné mes gouttes d'eau de ce côté-là avec de l'encre Versamark. Je l'ai embossé avec de la poudre transparente. J'ai fait mon fond, donc ça n'a pas pris sur les gouttes. Vous pouvez les laisser comme ça dans ce cas-là parce que de toute façon c'est des gouttes d'eau, donc c'est sympa quand ça brille. Ou alors, vous pouvez faire la technique du faux batik jusqu'au bout et enlever la poudre. Amandine, pas de souci. Donc vous voyez que ça reprend le... Ça enlève la poudre embossée en fait, ça la refait fondre, ça la met sur le papier et du coup vous avez des gouttes bien blanches avec votre fond, vos tampons sous les gouttes. So it removes the plasticky part of the embossing powder, sticks it to the paper, and then you've got your droplets, which are bright white, and you're stamping or stenciling behind the droplets, which is actually my favorite technique ever. All techniques, all like crafting techniques mixed, it's actually my favorite. It's always been my favorite. Been doing that for years. Right, so I'm going to add this on here. Any question? Nini, mais c'est pas grave, Nini, tu regardes pas après, t'inquiète. T'arrives pour le tirage au sort, toi, je te vois bien venir. J'adore les couleurs, mais c'est bien. Bon, alors, on va parler du tirage au sort. Donc, le gagnant ou la gagnante, autre que membre de ma famille, donc Amandine, tu peux pas jouer. Maman, tu peux pas jouer non plus. Ou Anaïs plus tard. Vous voulez gagner un de ces tampons, vous entrez le mot. Qu'est-ce qu'on va mettre? On va mettre digital, puisque le tampon, ça, ce sont des digitales. Donc vous mettez le mot digital pour pouvoir gagner une des planches que je vais montrer dans quelques minutes. For the English speaking ones, Christina, you've never seen that technique to remove the embossing. That's so old. That's actually the batik technique is used in India to where they put wax, they do all sorts of pattern with wax, and then they dye the cloth, and then they remove the wax, and that's how you get all those lovely patterns on Indian saris and things like that. So that's the same thing. It's called faux batik because we don't use wax, we use embossing powder. But it's a very old technique. I didn't invent anything by all means, but it's my favorite. I absolutely love it. I've just put that down. La, la, la. Damn it! Will it not? Sylvie, toi tu peux jouer. Bah oui, toi tu peux jouer. Okay, let's try again. That's the thing, you know, when you talk and do something at the same time. But that's good, you see me do something wrong. Try again. I need paper. je pars alors. Seen it with wax but not embossing powder. You heat set with a heat gun for the Vaseline. No, I didn't. I've tried both ways. I've tried heat setting it and not heat setting it, and it didn't make a difference. Sorry, I'm just getting some black paper. I much prefer the faux batik. I know it takes longer, but I prefer that technique. You you love to learn new techniques, and we all do, don't we? See, so I said at the beginning, I said, well, I'm going to use technique, you know, that are old and whatever, and but there's always someone who doesn't know one technique or another. Okay, so do as I said, don't do as I do. Let's try again. Right, I'm going to stop 2 seconds. Let's come to that too. So if you want to win one of those stamp plates, so either the fox gloves or the droplets or the branches or the doodles, the borders, you leave a comment with the word fox glove. Just write the word fox glove in a comment to enter the draw. And then I will do a draw sometimes by like tomorrow night probably. So if you watch on replay, you can play until tomorrow night, which is Sunday night. And Marie, tu peux participer, il n'y a pas de souci. C'est ouvert à tous les pays. Ça, il n'y a aucun souci, vas-y, n'hésite pas, hein, surtout. Hein. Je ne dis pas que tu vas gagner, mais tu peux participer. C'est ouvert à tous les pays. Il n'y a pas de préférence. So, if you want to enter and win one of these, what did I say, five? I've got one missing, no? Four, oh, no, five is the other one. Write the word foxglove ou digital en français. And I will do the draw tomorrow night. I will also send this card to someone else. I'm not going to do it to the same person. So one will receive the stamp plate, another one will receive the card. Not as much, not as good, I'm afraid, but you'll still have a card. Prix de consolation. Si vous n'avez pas les tampons, vous pouvez toujours avoir la carte. D'ailleurs, Marie, je me demandais où tu étais. Ça faisait un moment que je ne t'avais pas vue. J'y pensais l'autre jour. Quand je regardais les anciens... Je ne sais plus, je regardais les anciens commentaires sur un truc. Et je voyais ton nom. J'ai dit, tiens, ça fait un moment que je n'ai pas vu Marie. J'espère que tu vas bien. Okay, so Beatrice said, and I'm going to share that because I didn't know. So when you heat set the Vaseline, the paper will absorb the product and it will disappear, apparently. Donc si vous voulez gagner un des tampons ou la carte, vous mettez le mot digital avec un E parce que c'est la fleur en commentaire. Et on fera le tirage. Je ferai le tirage au sort demain soir, dimanche. Donc vous pouvez, si vous regardez en replay d'ici là, n'hésitez pas. Hein. Je prendrai tout en compte. C'est pas parce que vous n'étiez pas là pendant le live que ça compte pas. C'est moi qui envoie, t'inquiète. Donc voilà la réponse de Béatrice. Non, c'est toujours ouvert, c'est ouvert à tous les pays. Quand je fais des tirages au sort, il n'y a pas de... Il n'y a pas de raison. Hop. Je veux ce scotch double face. Je crois que je l'ai acheté soit chez Kerudoc, soit, comment ça s'appelait le site dont on parlait, Jackson's Art something, en Angleterre. D'ailleurs, si t'en commandes, tu me le dis parce qu'il m'en faut d'autres. On se fera une commande ensemble. Parce que c'est mon dernier. Je vais bien, j'avais pas activé les notifications. Ah bah alors... tant que je suis là, le prochain live, ce sera, c'est le premier samedi de juin. Ça fait quoi ça? Ça fait le 5, je peux pas regarder le calendrier sur le truc. Le 5 juin? Tu veux le lien, mais tu l'auras tout à l'heure. Le premier samedi du mois, c'est quoi? C'est le 5? Donc, il y aura un prochain live pour les nouveaux tampons de Craft Individuals. As I'm here, the next live will be beginning of June. The first Saturday of June, I think it's the 5th. I'm not too sure. But just after it will be for the new Craft Individuals stamps release. So that will be the next live. Le 5, merci Amandine. So it is the 5th. I was right. Okay, so let's put these. Je ne participerai pas, j'ai déjà gagné une fois, mais bravo à Béatrice pour ces jolis tampons, c'est vrai qu'ils sont super beaux. Il faut reconnaître. Bon, il ne faut pas lui dire de trop, Béatrice, parce qu'elle va se prendre la grosse tête, mais c'est vrai qu'ils sont super beaux quand même. Five, c'est bien. Les gouttes d'eau, c'est une artiste de l'Ontario. Je sais pas, Béatrice, les gouttes d'eau, c'est une artiste de l'Ontario, je pense pas. Hein. Enfin, je m'avance peut-être, mais je crois pas. Pourquoi tu dis ça? Il y en a une à l'Ontario qui le fait aussi. Ça, des gouttes d'eau, hein, c'est facile à faire. Hein. Ça peut être des artistes de n'importe où. Qui c'est qui l'a fait en Ontario? J'ai réservé mon billet pour aller au Canada, mais j'ai un gros doute là. Je sens que ça ne va pas le faire. Parce que pour l'instant, il y a 14 jours de quarantaine. Donc si je passe 14 jours dans l'appartement de mon fils, que j'adore, d'accord, mais bon. Si je vais au Canada, c'est pas pour. C'est pas pour rester enfermé. Même pas, je te réponds. Mais c'est pas moi qui pose la question. C'est Marie qui pose la question. C'est à toi de donner la réponse, c'était ton ton. Il y en a partout des gouttes d'eau. Celle-ci, ah non, c'est Léa qui les a dessinées. Et comme je disais, les gouttes d'eau, il y en a plein qui le font. C'est un des premiers trucs qu'on apprend à faire quand on fait de l'aquarelle. Les gouttes d'eau. Ah, merde, oh, pardon. J'ai rien dit. J'ai tout enlevé. Je vais y arriver avec ce truc ou pas? Voilà. Right. So, I'm going to put the little one in the middle. This one on this side. Si j'ai vu tous les commentaires, mais je les relirai ce soir de toute façon. Je répondrai après. Hein. Si jamais j'ai raté un truc, vous inquiétez pas, je les relis après. If I've missed any comments and or questions or whatever, I'm not ignoring you, but just I can't read everything and do that at the same time. But I will read again tonight and I will answer any questions that I've missed. On the other one, I did some washi tape, but I'm not going to do it on this one, so I think that's enough. So I'm going to use the 2 millimeters to put that on the panel. Un petit rappel encore une fois pour gagner une des planches que je viens d'utiliser aujourd'hui. Vous laissez le mot digital, qui est le nom des fleurs. Donc avec un E, dans un commentaire. Si vous regardez en replay, vous pouvez participer jusqu'à demain soir, dimanche. Dimanche 23. Et je ferai le tirage au sort, soit demain soir, soit lundi, je verrai. Le mot magique, c'est digital, mon étampe préférée, les bordures. Ben après, Celle qui gagne, je lui demanderai ce qu'elle veut après, hein. C'est pas la peine de le mettre maintenant. So, if you want to enter to win the stamps, one of the stamp sets, your choice. All you have to do is write the word foxglove in a comment and you can win the stamp. If you're watching this on replay, you can enter until tomorrow night, Sunday, 23rd of May, and I will do the draw tomorrow night or on Monday. So this one is an A5. In inches, it's, I don't know, what is it in inches? It's about, it's nearly 6 inches, but not quite, by 8 1/4. Thank you, Caroline. I will add the sentiments later. I don't know what I'll put. So remember, just type the word foxglove in the comments to win one of the stamp set. One person will win the stamp set and stamp plate, and another one I will send a card to. As I always do, all the cards that I make during my lives, I always send to someone who's watching as a thank you for watching me. Here we go. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all the lovely comments. All right, so let me show you one last time. This one. So if you write the word foxglove, si vous écrivez le mot digital en commentaire, vous pouvez gagner un de ces tampons. Et ce sera votre choix. Soit les bordures, so it can be the borders, it can be the branches, grass, les herbes folles, it can be the water droplets, or it can be the foxglove. So write the word foxglove in a comment and you will win, you can win, not you will, you might win, one of those, and someone else will get the card. Donc une personne gagnera une des planches et une autre personne, j'enverrai la carte à une autre personne. So, any question, ladies, before I switch it off? Bleach. Stop it with your bleach. Stop spamming me with your bleach. My tea is cold. Est-ce que quelqu'un a des questions? Si vous regardez ça en replay, vous pouvez toujours mettre le mot digital plus tard, jusqu'à demain soir, dimanche 23 mai. Ça marche aussi. Merci Sylvie. Ça change, hein? De la bleue et jaune, j'aime bien les deux. Elle est un tout petit peu plus petite que la tienne. You're very welcome, Christina. You're welcome, Sally. Thank you, Cathy. So don't forget to type the word foxglove in a comment to win a either a stamp plate or the card. You're welcome, Monique. De rien, Marie. Ça me fait très plaisir de te revoir. Enfin, de revoir. entre guillemets, de te relire. Merci, Lini. Ah, tu peux toujours comment participer pour gagner la carte, Nini, quand même. C'est pas la même chose que de gagner les tampons. You're welcome, Caroline. Bye. Beautiful card. Thank you so much. You always, there's always something to learn, even if you're an avid crafter and been crafting for years. I still learn. I've been crafting for 18 years now, and I'm still learning. You're welcome, Pearl. Always nice to see you here. All right, ladies. I will see you in a couple of weeks for the new Craft Individuals release. In the meantime, have a lovely weekend. Merci à celles qui sont passées ou à celles qui regarderont en replay après. Je vous retrouve dans 2 semaines normalement pour les nouveaux tampons de Craft Individuals. Il ne faut pas le rater celui-là parce que franchement, ils sont trop, trop, trop beaux. Je me suis éclatée à faire les cartes. Donc voilà, donc n'hésitez pas à participer si vous voulez gagner des tampons jusqu'à demain soir dimanche 23. Et voilà, à bientôt. Salut, bye everyone.